Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's video, we're going to solve a trigonometric equation on the interval 0 to 2 pi. Here we see with the interval notation, we have a closed bracket over the 0, so that means the 0 is included. We have an open parenthesis over the 2 pi, so that means the 2 pi is excluded. We're looking for all the solutions that appear in between those two values. Alright, next thing to notice is that the equation is tangent squared theta times sine theta equals 0. These two trig functions are actually factors. We're multiplying them together, and that comes out to have a product of 0. Because of that, we can use something called the zero property. And with the zero property, that just means that I can separate this into two different equations. The first equation being tangent squared theta equals 0. The second equation being sine theta is equal to 0. Let's focus on this tangent squared theta equals 0 first. We need to break that down. So to do that, we need to take the square root of both sides because the square root is the opposite of the square. And in doing that, the tangent squared just becomes a tangent theta, and the square root of 0 is just 0. Now let's look at breaking down tangent theta, the trig function, even more. Tangent theta is the same thing as sine theta over cosine theta. And from previous trig courses and other videos, we know that sine theta corresponds to the y coordinate and cosine theta corresponds to the x coordinate. All right, now to help us visually see how to solve this equation, let's fall back to the unit circle. So we're going to draw in our coordinate plane, and we're going to draw in a circle. It's called a unit circle because its radius is just one unit. All right, so let's look at the points on the coordinate plane that are valuable when trying to solve these trig equations. So here I put in some points. This first point, if I were to move one unit over, that means my x value was 1. I did not go up or down, so my y value was 0. Over here, I did not move left or right, so my x value was 0. I did move up 1, so my y value was 1. Over here, I moved to the left 1 value, so that's one unit, so that's negative 1. I did not go up or down, so the y is 0. And down here, I did not move left or right, so the x is 0, but I did move down 1 unit, so the y is negative 1. And lastly, let me go ahead and add in the radian measures as we go around the unit circle. Here we begin at 0 radians. Up here is pi over 2 radians. Let me make that a little bit neater. Up here is pi over 2 radians. Over here is pi radians. Down here is 3 pi over 2 radians. And when we get back to 0, we're at 2 pi. All right, let's also show that the first coordinate is the x value. The second coordinate is the y value. And like we said earlier, cosine corresponds to x. So the first value corresponds to cosine. And sine corresponds to y. So the second value corresponds to sine. All right, now, as we look at this equation, we want the tangent of one of these radian measures to come out to be 0. If we use this fraction y over x, then we can take each one of these points and create a fraction using numbers and see which one evaluates to 0. So let's start here at 0 and 2 pi. We're going to put the y value over the x value, so that's going to be 0 over 1. Well, 0 over 1 does resolve down to 0, so that means 0 and 2 pi are values of theta that will result in a 0. All right, let's look at pi over 2. That would be 1 over 0. Well, we know that we can't have a denominator of 0. That makes this undefined, so we can't use pi over 2. Let's come here to pi. We're going to have 0 over negative 1. Well, that's still going to result to 0, so that means pi is a good answer or possible solution. And when we get down here to 3 pi over 2, we end up with negative 1 over 0, which again is undefined, so we can't use that. So for the tangent, we see that we have these three possible solutions, but note that 2 pi needs to be excluded, so we cannot use 2 pi here. Let's look at the next, or the second equation that we made, sine theta. We said earlier that sine theta corresponds to y, so we're looking at our y values, and wherever our y value comes out to be 0, we know that's what we want to use. So here at 0 and 2 pi, my y value is 0, so I can use that for theta. When I come here to pi over 2, it's at 1 for y, so I can't use that. When I come down here to pi, I'm at the y coordinate is at 0, so I can use that. And I see I left off the 2 pi, so let's add the 2 pi in here, and then also pi. And when I get down here to 3 pi over 2, we see the y value is negative 1. We know that we can't use that because the result should be 0. And again, we have to exclude 2 pi because of the limitation here of the interval. So here we're seeing that the values of theta to solve this problem, theta can be 0 and theta can be pi. Now let's pull up the calculator so that we can visually verify these results. So let's go ahead. First, make sure your calculator is in radian mode. You do that by clicking on mode and then coming down, using the arrows to come down to radians. But you want to go ahead and put in those two, or put in the equation. And the equation that we're starting with here is tangent x squared times sine theta, or I'm sorry, times sine x. And then let's graph. All right, we see the graphs being drawn in. And what we're going to look for is where the graph crosses this x-axis. Where the graph crosses the x-axis, we know that the y-value at that location is 0. But let's zoom in because we have a lot of x-values that we don't need. We want to have x-values that are limited to our interval, which we said was from 0 to 2 pi. So let's go to window. And let's see the x minimum. Let's make that negative 1/10, because we want to show 0 on our graph. And let's show the max. Let's make that 2 pi plus 1/10. So we're just larger than the interval that we were limited to in the problem, and we need to do that so the calculator doesn't error out when we try to find what the answers are. So when I graph, let's also limit the y-axis as well so we can get a little bit closer. So let's go back to window, and then let's go down to the y minimum. Let's make that y minimum negative 1. Let's make that y maximum a positive 1. And again, let's graph so we can get in a little bit closer. All right, we see that the blue is our equation. And we see here that we appear to be touching or crossing this x-axis in this region, and a region over here, and over here. So it appears to be three different locations. Let's take a look at the table. So second, and then graph again to get to the table. And like I said earlier, whenever we're touching or crossing the x-axis, the y value is going to be 0. So here, when y is 0, we see that we have an x value of 0, which is one of the solutions. When y is 0, we're at 3.1416, which is the approximation of pi. We're at 0 again at 6.28. This is the approximation for 2 pi. So again, this here proves that our two solutions are at 0 and pi to be limited by the interval notation that was stated in the beginning. All right, that sums up this video for Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.